Well, good morning and welcome to another episode of Shelter Daily in His Word. Thank you for tuning in. Today's a great day. Today's an important day because today is the day that has been designated for everyone around the globe to share the gospel with someone. So I hope that you'll challenge your heart today and just share the gospel with somebody, and that God would just speak to their hearts and God would touch them. I believe without a doubt that God has prepared the fields. Jesus said the fields are white and they're ready for harvest. And it's up to you and I, laborers, to go into the field of harvest. So the challenge is today is as we pray, and we're going to pray right now for open doors. Maybe some people have already been able to do so. But we want to pray for open doors today, that God will help us to share the word, and then we'll get into the word this morning. So Father, thank you for the opportunity we have today, Lord, on this day especially, where millions of people around the world are going to be sharing the gospel. So I just pray today, God, that you will allow us, God, the opportunities, open doors, God. We've been praying for these doors to open. We're believing, God, for people. Now we go in with boldness just to share the good news with somebody. And God, to share that with them. And God, we're going to hear good reports. We're going to hear great things to come. And we believe, God, that testimonies will come from this, God, that people's lives will be changed, transformed. And God, they'll be renewed and brought into the kingdom. Backsliders will come home. Sons and daughters will come home. And God, we're just going to believe for that today. So touch us today. Bless the word today as we talk more about the importance of intercession, God, and how we intercede and advocate for the lost. This is the reason why we intercede for people. And today, God, you'll do that. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, if you have your Bibles and you'd like to open with me and you want to go back, we're going to go back to Colossians chapter 1, verses 9 through 12. And we're going to look at Colossians 1, 9 through 12 just for a moment more. And as we talk about this idea of intercession, and the importance of intercession in evangelism, when we think about intercession, that you and I are advocating for the lives of others. And Paul made this declaration in Colossians chapter 1. He said, "For this reason, we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you and to ask that you may be filled with a knowledge of his will and all wisdom and spiritual understanding." So here, you know, the Apostle Paul, again, is giving us this insight that as we're praying, he's praying for the church, he's praying for the people of God, that they will be filled with the knowledge of the will and the wisdom of God, the spiritual understanding. We need, you know, in our day and time, we need that more than anything else. There is so much going on in our world that when we're people of prayer, we need to have the wisdom and the knowledge and spiritual understanding to know how to handle and deal with the matters that that we're being confronted with. And then he goes on, he says in verse 10, he says that you may walk worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing him, being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God, strengthened with all might, verse 11 says. So here, again, think about what he's saying. He's saying that we are to walk worthy of the Lord. And when I think about that, I think about how that the Lord's done so much in our lives. And sometimes, you know, the truth of the matter is I feel unworthy. There's times when I don't feel like I measure up to what God is even thinking about or what he even desires for my life. And yet, the encouraging word is that the prayer that we pray for the believer is that we would walk worthy. You know, my prayer for us as a church, that we as a people, that we'll walk worthy of the Lord, that we'll please him above everything. You know, the idea of pleasing God above pleasing ourselves, so that we're fruitful in every good work and we increase in the knowledge of God. So when you're fruitful in the work of God, the knowledge of God increases in your life. And so you think about that the idea here is that we, by the spiritual understanding, become knowledgeable of the things God is doing, and that the work that we do, we zero in on the work that brings the greatest fruit. So we look for the things, we see the things that the God of heaven directs us to by his wisdom, his knowledge. He shows us as we walk with him, and then we, so this is where where you think about, as you're looking at the whole circumstance and situation of dealing with praying for people who are lost without God. You know, the Bible talks about how that we're to bear fruit, and that we're to bear more fruit, and that we're to bear much fruit. And that when we don't bear fruit, he comes along and he prunes the vine, and you know, he's the vine dresser, and you know, he comes along and he lifts up the vine that gets down in the dirt, and he pulls it up and he ties it off, and he cleans it up, and he does that because he wants that vine. He wants you and I to be, as we're grafted into the things God is doing, he wants us to be fruitful in the work that we do. And so he tells us that when we understand, as we increase in the knowledge of God, we understand that we can be more fruitful because we are walking in and doing the things that God asks us to do. And then he goes on and he says that strengthened with all might according to his glorious power, for all patience and long-suffering with joy, giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us. You know, a lot of times in the world that we live in, we are looking for the world to qualify us. You know, if we don't have the right qualifications, if we don't have the right education. I remember years ago when before I ever finished pursuing my education, I remember getting a phone call from the FBI, and they wanted me to become a chaplain for the FBI, and I found out that I was the only chaplain in the entire corps of chaplains for the FBI that didn't have a degree. And I thought, man, you know, this is really kind of weird, because here these guys are, some of them have doctorates, some of them have masters, and others, you know, have other, and all kinds of degrees, and they got all kinds of names, letters behind their name. And here I was, the only letter I had behind my name was nothing. And then I got to thinking, but you know what? I didn't ask for the job. They called me, I didn't call them. And the reason they called me was because God qualified me for the job. God qualified me. See, my connection with the Father opened a door for me to do something that in myself I would have never been able to do. And that's what God wants to do. So we give thanks to God because he's the one that qualifies us. He qualifies you to do the work that you're doing. Sometimes I know you feel inadequate. Sometimes you don't feel like you're equipped. Sometimes you feel like, man, I fall short. And there's nothing wrong with, you know, educating yourself and learning and growing in those things. But, and that's the reason why we do these sessions, because these sessions help us to grow, and we're talking about prayer, so we're learning how to pray better. And I say that, I don't mean like we're going to say better prayers. I'm saying that because I want us to learn how to approach God in such a way that we maximize the time we have with him, and we don't find ourselves just kind of all over the map. And sometimes we're like that. But he's the one who qualifies us, and we're partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light. So we're the partakers of the things that God is doing, and this is what God calls us to do and to be. And nothing will deepen our love for people. And so I said this, you know, the other day. I said nothing will deepen your love for people than when you pray for them, when you're interceding for them. That's what intercession does. And you step into the gap, and you feel, well, am I really qualified? You know, when you think about praying for people, you think, man, you know, there's some people, you know, I've done way worse things than they've done, and who am I to be praying for them? Well, you know, God saved you, didn't he? He qualified you. So he put you into a place to where you are advocating in the behalf of the needs of those around you. So family members who sometimes, you know, they say, you know, a prophet's not without honor, except among his own people. But who qualified you to speak forth the word of life? Who qualified you to say the things that you're saying? Who qualified you to stand in the gap? The only one that qualified you is the Father. So allow him to do this, and allow him, and this is done when you have this communion with God. And this is one of the things that we have to understand, that if we're going to win souls, then we must claim them in our times of prayer first. Doesn't do us any good to be out there in the world and we're rubbing shoulders in the world and stuff like that. We're having to live in this world. We're having to be a people in the world that we live in. But yet, at the same time, if we're going to claim the world, if we're going to claim lost people, we have to do that in the private prayer closet of prayer. And one of the things that I notice about this, and this is what I want to take you into this morning, is that this idea of intercession helps us to understand, you know, more about who the character, or what the character of God is. When I think about the character of God, I realize that, you know, God's character is if I think about it for myself, it's like, man, I fall short. But prayer is an indicator of our faith, not only in God's ability, but in the character of God as well. When we pray, when a child cries out for his mother, that child cries out because he knows that the mother's character that she is a woman of compassion. And because she's a woman of compassion, she's going to help. So think about this. So when I cry out to God, because he knows his nature, and because we know his nature, we know his character. We know his character is one of love. We know his character is one of goodness. We know his character is one of full of mercy. So when we cry out to God, when we're crying out to him, we're crying out to him because we know that God hears us. And we know that God will answer us. You know, we wouldn't cry out to God if his character wasn't such. If he lacked care, if he lacked compassion, if he lacked those things, we wouldn't be crying out to God. We wouldn't, in fact, we wouldn't even bother. This is the reason why I know that a lot of times, you know, even people that don't even believe, you know, in God, there's a lot of times they'll say, you know, I got to pray. You know, they feel this urgency, this something inside of them that causes them to cry out. Why? Because they're looking for mercy. They're looking for the compassion that only God can bring. Now, in our world we're living in right now, you know, there's a movement of people out there. And there always has been people who say, well, prayer doesn't do anything. Prayer doesn't mean anything. And yet we know that even, you know, people always talk about how they need to believe in science. Okay, well, even science has proven that prayer is effective for people, especially patients, when they're getting ready to go into surgery. When one prays for a patient before surgery, it calms them. It brings a sense of peace to them. It does something. So even scientists have said, hey, look, there's something about prayer. And the reason for that is because every one of us understands, you know, that God, even though many don't believe in God, there's people say, I don't believe in God. At the end of the day, those that do believe in God know that God is a God of compassion. He has a character of care and compassion. If he didn't, we wouldn't sense that calm. We wouldn't sense that come over us. And so when I think about the character of God when we're going to prayer and we're praying for people, the reason why we can come to God, the person we may be praying for may be a scoundrel. They may be the worst of the worst. You know, they may have done heinous things. And yet, because God is a God of compassion, and we cry out and be in their behalf, God can change them. I remember my dad years ago telling a story about how the Lord moved upon him to pray for Johnny Cash. And he said, you know, back when Johnny Cash wasn't serving the Lord, he said, I really felt an urgency to pray just to call on God in behalf of him. Now, he didn't know him, didn't know who he was, never met him, but he just had a sense of intercession in behalf. Well, you know, whether or not it was my dad's prayer that actually brought Johnny Cash back into the kingdom, you know, it could be debated, but the reality is that Johnny Cash ended up coming to know Christ, and he came back to the Lord. And I do believe that it is the effectual, fervent prayers of righteous people that avail much. Now, again, we can debate whether or not it was that prayer specifically or not. There are probably hundreds of other people praying. And maybe because I believe that the Lord lays that on the hearts of many, you know, and I'm glad of that. I'm glad that God doesn't just lay it on my heart to pray, because, you know, there's been times when I've been negligent in prayer. There's been times when I missed the opportunity to pray. But aren't you glad that God lays it on not only my heart, but others? You see, this idea of compassion is, you can really see this in the life of Christ, especially when he's getting ready to go to the cross and he goes to Gethsemane after he's met in the upper, you know, with his last meal with his disciples, and they go on this little walk. They go into the Garden of Gethsemane, which he often had done. They go to the Garden of Gethsemane, and there the Bible says that he drew away from the disciples, and he went off into this secluded place and he began to pray. And the Bible describes the level of compassion that Jesus had as he was crying out. The Bible says that as he cried out, the ground, you know, was filled with tears, and he poured it out. He just poured out himself, you know. And some would say, well, he was, you know, because of what was going on. No, it was because of what he knew. He knew what he was doing. He knew that this was the time. He was interceding in the behalf of those who God had, his Father had put into his care. He was interceding in the behalf of you and me. And his heart was torn because of the compassion. You know, this is intercession that comes deep within us. When Christ cried out, he cried out for all of humanity. And the idea of crying out in a holy desperation on the edge of a breakthrough and praying and crying out, this is where we are. This is what we do. And I think about the opportunities as we come together for prayer, and we'll pray together. And part of the reason we pray together is to intercede, to advocate for your family, your sons and your daughters, your mothers and fathers, your friends and relatives, people that you're close to, your inner circle, the people you're connected to. We cry out to God for them, interceding on their behalf. And it's knowing the compassionate heart of God that causes us to feel within us that it's okay to bring even the worst of the worst sinners. Paul said, I was the chief of them, he said. But knowing that even the chief of sinners, God saved. Even the worst of the worst, God redeemed. And that's exactly what he wants to do for your lost loved ones, your lost friends. I just feel an oversensing presence of God right here, just saying, it's time. We need to pray for the open door. We need to pray because the God of compassion, he loves his creation. He said, I love the world so much that I gave my only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Why don't we do that right now? Why don't we just pause right now? That person that you know, that individual that you know, that one that's been, maybe it's a neighbor that you've been talking to. You've been praying for them. Maybe you've opened up that app called Bless Every Home, and it's giving you names of neighbors, and you've been praying for your neighbors. Maybe it's a relative. Maybe it's a mother, a father, a son, or a daughter. It could be somebody very close to you, but whoever they are, would you right now, would you just pause and just say, God, out of compassion, would you touch their life? Father, I believe today that you're a God of compassion. That's your character. That's who you are. And God, as we intercede for the lost, as we intercede for people, as we cry out, God, for doors of opportunity, God, to rise up for us so we can speak words, God, of life. We speak it, God, out of a heart of compassion, out of a heart of care, of love. Lord, it's not out of anger. It's not out of frustration that we say the things we do. Truly, Lord, we know that when we see things that are going on in people's lives, especially those that we care about, it breaks our hearts. And God, we know, Lord, and we ought to pray, Lord, as we've heard it said so many times, we ought to pray, God, in such a way that we begin to see the things that break your heart. And whatever breaks your heart, God, let it break ours. And so lost people today, God, they break your heart. And Lord God, it ought to break ours too. And so God, move us with compassion for them. Draw us to you, I pray. In Jesus' name we ask. Amen. Amen. Well, I want to thank you for joining with me again for another episode of this Shelter Daily in His Word. I love these opportunities. And if you've enjoyed these, again, I say this, hit the like button. Tell us that you like it. Share it with somebody. Share what you're hearing with someone else. Let them know. And then connect to us at JubileeWorshipCenter.com, because we'd love to hear from you. We'd love to hear what God's doing in your life. We'd love to hear your testimonies. Maybe you've got a chance to witness to somebody and you want to just share that with us. We'd love to be able to share that with even people that are watching us right now. So God bless you. Have a great day. We look forward to seeing you tomorrow for another episode of Shelter Daily in His Word. Thank you.
all of